News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Sian and joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hi, Sian. Hi, everybody.
What story do you have for us today?
Today, Sian, we have a story about a very hot topic.
Oh, can you guess what it is? Let's find out from this BBC Radio 4 news bulletin.
2016 is on course to be the warmest year on record, and it will be the third year in a row that a new record has been set. The findings were announced at a meeting of the UN Weather Agency, the World Meteorological Organization, in Marrakesh in Morocco. Climate scientists said that although the El Niño weather phenomenon had had an impact, carbon emissions were the most significant factor. 16 of the 17 warmest years in history have been recorded this century.
So, a story there about the Earth's temperature, and 2016 is almost definitely going to be the hottest year since humans started recording the temperature.
Okay, so a worrying story.
It's quite serious, yeah.
And so what words and phrases are being used by news sites online to talk about this story?
Okay, well, we're going to look at two groups of words. The first group of three words all have a very similar meaning, and the words are sweltering, sizzling and scorching. Our second group of phrases also have very similar meanings to each other, and they are on course, on track and on pace.
OK, and how are the first group of words appearing in the news stories?
OK, so let's look at the headlines then. We have Global News website tells us scorching 2016 on pace to be hottest year on record. Secondly, from the Australian website In Daily, we have sweltering 2016 to set heat record. And in the story itself, we're told the world is set to notch up a new heat record in 2016 after a sizzling 2015.
All right, so we have scorching, sizzling and sweltering, which are all extreme adjectives meaning very, very, very hot.
Very, very, very hot, yes.
And they all have pretty much a similar meaning. It's not one's more extreme than the other, is it?
No, not at all. All of them mean very, very, very hot. They're not particularly graded. So if you want to describe a situation where something is extremely hot, use your favourite.
So it's quite nice because headlines can vary their language with all these different synonyms.
They do, and they're all quite dramatic as well. Yes. So good for headlines, yeah.
And as they're extreme, we have to use an extreme adverb. So we can't use very sweltering, can we?
Not at all. No, you would say absolutely scorching, for example, yeah.
Now, we've both got quite thick jumpers on today, haven't
well,
we?
Well, it was cold on the way to work this morning.
Yeah, it was,
yeah.
But in this office, it's sweltering with all the lights.
The light, computers. Yes, it is actually. I'm feeling quite warm as well, actually.
Yeah.
In fact, more than quite warm. This office, this studio is sweltering.
Sweltering, scorching.
Yes.
Yeah, sizzling. And now sizzle, the verb sizzle makes me think of bacon, sausages.
Cooking.
Yes.
Cooking in a frying pan in particular. So if you've got a pan, you're cooking your dinner, lots of oil in the pan and something that's quite fatty. So when you put it in the pan, it goes spitting and hissing and bubbling and smelling lovely. And the noise it makes in particular sounds like the word sizzle. So sizzle means cooking something so that it's spitting and making a lot of frying noise. Yeah.
So sausages sizzle. Yeah.
Sausages sizzle. You're making me hungry.
I'm getting quite hungry as well. OK, so let's move on to the next group of words then. What do we have for the next group of words?
OK, so let's go back to our headlines and we're looking at USA Today 2016 on track for hottest year on record. Al Jazeera tell us 2016 on course to be hottest year on record. And our final one, back to Global News, and we have scorching 2016 on pace to be hottest year on record. So almost identical headlines there, which tells us that the words are probably pretty similar.
Yes, so we have on course, on track and on pace.
Yep.
And they mean happening in the way we expect based on what's been happening until now, doesn't it?
Exactly that, yes. So there's a kind of, you know what's going to happen. The result will be because of what's happened leading up to this moment. Often it's used for plans. So for or plans or things you want to happen. So for example, you're at school. You want to get a final grade A at the end of the year. If you look at all your essays and your grades you've had so far, you've had maybe 4 A's and 2 B's. So looking at that, you're likely to get a final grade A. You're on course to get a final grade A because you've had quite a few grade A's up till now.
So it's often quite positive, but in these stories, it's not a positive use, is it? It's used for something quite negative.
It is, and it's quite unusual, but I think it works, and they've used it because we're talking about the hottest year on record. So it's a kind of record. It's actually something that's never been done before. And often that's quite positive if you think of Olympic athletes breaking records. So even though this result will be negative, we're using it in this kind of record way. So generally speaking, on course and on track are for positive things. Here it's been played around with a little bit,
And we're using it here because 2016 isn't over yet. We're in November, so we can't say for definite because something may happen. We may have a cold spell in December and it may change it, but it's looking likely.
It's looking very, very likely. And that's the key with on course, on track, on pace. It's looking very likely.
And on course and on track are much more common, aren't they, than on pace?
Much more common. Yes, on course, on track. Those are the ones we see more often. The newspapers chose on pace, but I think it's less common.
And it kind of, if you think about the literal meaning of a course and track, it makes sense, doesn't it? Because if you're on course or on track, you're on a journey somewhere, on a route.
Yeah, a course and a path are often literally like pavements, or you go to a stadium. There's a running track where athletes run, so it's literally what you move on.
And what follows? If we want to use a noun or a verb, what structure do we use?
Well, with on course and on track, you can use, you can follow them by four plus a noun phrase, or you can follow them both by to be and a verb phrase. And it's the same for on pace, but again, just a little more unusual to see those structures.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, before we recap, let's look at our Facebook challenge. So we asked you, we've been exploring some idioms related to track. Which of these track idioms can we use when we travel to places where not many people go? A, make tracks. B, lose track. Or C, go off the beaten track. What kind of responses did we have?
Fantastic responses, always. We caught a few people out with make tracks. A few people thought that the answer was make tracks. That wasn't quite correct. The answer we were looking for was answer C, which was go off the beaten track. So well done, Jan Lopez, Aisha Mark and Yuko Nakani, as well as everybody else who got that correct.
Well done. And to find out the meaning of those other two track idioms, go to our website, bbclearningenglish.com. Now, before we make tracks, Catherine, can you recap the words and phrases we've heard today?
Most definitely. So we had sweltering, sizzling and scorching, which are all extreme adjectives which mean very, very hot. Then we had on course, on track and on pace, which refer to things which are happening the way we expect them to based on what has happened until now.
Okay, and if you'd like to test yourself on these words and phrases, go to our website, bbclearningenglish.com. Now, I think it's time for us to leave this sweltering studio.
Yes, please.
So, see you soon. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
News Review from BBC Learning English.